to make sure, could you please count to 10 for me? To us, as we do not want to inflict any harm of any kind. We are simply here to do some mild testing. Good. Okay. Besides, I assume that the beloved professor wouldn't want his babies being messed with, so. Good. So what we're going to be doing today, I'm going to have a look at your skin. I'm going to be testing your ability to follow certain instructions, okay? Good. And really a bit of everything. A bit of a cranial nerve exam. I wanted to take some hair samples. I mean, you are very hairy, so I think that shouldn't be too difficult. So, let's have a look, yeah. Because you do have three eyes. Do all the eyes function the same way? So that one tends to, okay, see better in the dark. Okay, that is excellent. I'm just going to take down some notes, if you don't mind. Here you are. Experiment 420. Good. Okay. So let's just write down the date first. Okay. Tested for allergies yet, by any chance? Mm-hmm. What was the outcome of that? Okay. That's good. Mm-hmm. And what food do they give you? Pretty much just, okay. So, a relatively human diet, apart from the glass. Okay, alright. Okay. Mm-hmm. This could be interesting. How about, do you have a favourite colour? What's that? I don't believe that is a colour. Or at least, I've never heard of it. Is that colour somewhere on me right now? No. Interesting. How do I spell that? Well, there is a possibility that you can detect a certain level of bioluminescence. Although your eyes don't really indicate. Good. Could test it, I suppose, but Are there any other colours that you could think of that you like? Blue? Mm-hmm. What kind of blue? Like a strong royal blue, or marine blue, powder blue? Okay. Mm-hmm. So, I think I have everything else written down for now. So, if you don't mind, I will be been working my way to the ears as well. We're doing this to test your sensitivity. I would like to quickly ask you to tell me, we're going to be using this soft Q-tip here and then the sharp edge of this pen, and you tell me while you have all your eyes closed which one I touched your skin with. Okay, good. So close your eyes. I'm going to start now. Dot. Mm-hmm. Dot. Very good. Okay. Dot, dot. Good. Dot, dot, dot. Mm-hmm. Dot, dot, dot. Very, very good. Dot, dot, dot. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Good. Now, and as I'm here, I'm just going to be taking a little skin sample just at the very outside. Mm-hmm. Good. Mm-hmm. Then we're going to just put it inside this bag here. Okay. Excellent. Very good. So, what I'll be doing next is I'm going to just have a little closer inspection of your skin with this light, okay? Very good. So I'm just gonna get a bit closer and have a look here. If there's anything that I can see that we need to take a closer look at. Mm-hmm. Yes, it is quite stormy outside, isn't it? Yes. You wouldn't think that on a stormy day they would be doing any building work, but oh well. Yes, I do apologize if it's a little bit loud, but I will send you back to sleep very soon, don't you worry. Okay. Mm-hmm. I do see a little bit of redness. Have they taken you out into the sun? Oh, okay. Still very sensitive. Mm-hmm. That would make a lot of sense, of course, yes. Good. What SPF do they use on you? Oh, okay. Surprises me that they would take you out in the first place, then. Strange. But does it hurt at all? No? Okay, very good. Very good. Very good. We want to be very careful. I hope they give you something. Skin down afterwards, maybe like a cooling pad or maybe some ice gloves. Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Good. Okay. Now, you can open your eyes properly. All of them, good. So, could you, while you keep your head still, could you follow the light with all your eyes? Yeah, all of them? Good. Okay. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Okay. Right, just across from side to side. Go a bit faster now. Okay, very good. Now could you close that eye for me? We follow again. other side. Open the other one again. Okay. And now close the two front eyes and only look with the top. Very, very good. Okay, okay. Very good. Okay. So, let's have a look. That didn't hurt, did it? Gonna quickly write that down. Don't mind. So, So have they given you your daily face cream yet? They haven't. Okay. We'll do that in a minute then. But first, I'm going to be brushing your face a little bit just to get more of the particles so that we can send them into the lab and see what has changed. Good. Okay. So mold. What is this here? How long have you been with us now? Oh, okay, so this was the old protocol. That does make sense. Okay, very good. So, let's take the cream here. This is the one, correct? We'll be using that in a moment, but we'll be using this brush here. The other one is a little bit too small, I believe. Okay. So, get this little bag, open that up. Over your face like this. Very good. Very good. Just stay still for me, okay? Want to get nice coverage on the brush. So just relax, okay? Good. Just stay nice and calm. Forehead, of course, can't forget the forehead. Good. And along the nose. Okay, good. Don't worry, I won't touch your eyes. I'll be very careful. And along your chin, of course. Good. I'm just going to go around the neck area as well. Good to get everything nice and covered. Okay, very good. Okay. Now we wanted to label that. Final piece that I want to send off to the lab. I'm also going to be snipping some of your hair. That's okay. Good. So just gently going in. Ever so gently, okay. do look very sleepy. Be very careful not to, tug on the skin. So they know that this is from you. Okay. Alright. Now, let's apply the cream, shall we? Good. So, how much do they usually use? Pea-sized amount. Okay. So, this will do. Okay. Very good. So this is to protect both skin and hair. And then we just cover you nice and gently. Nice and gentle. Get that worked in. Good. Does that feel good? Good. Move that along your jawline. Just raise your head a little tiny bit for me. Good. Do they go along the ears as well? So she won't need the gloves. So, put these away. Right, so you just let that sit, okay? I'm just going to add another little info in here. I think from what your skin looks like now, I think we could actually put you into the next testing phase soon. Since we obviously want you to be able to walk around in the sun without too much damage, we would need to also do some other tests with well, a certain level of sharpness and softness, just so that your skin doesn't appear too unhuman, because ultimately that is what you will be transforming into. Okay. So here is one of the designs that we picked for you. You liked that one best, didn't you?
Did.
Okay. Right. So, I'm going to ask them that in about a week's time they transfer you into the other office. You're going to grow in size as well. I'd say about maybe 10 to 20 inches. Yeah. Round about, yeah. It always kind of depends on how quickly you grow and how much you eat. Questions so far. I've only seen you, I think, a few times now. There's not really that much that you would have to learn about humans other than what you already know. Humans are strange and, well, strange. So, I think it's all very much learning by doing. Plus, most of us here are humans, so you've already been able to get a glance at what you're going to be seeing out in the open. Yeah. But we do have every handbook that there is ready for you if you need anything, of course, yes. Yeah, exactly. Okay. So, I'm going to program you back to sleep now. Is that okay? If you do need anything, obviously you can wake up again. You do know that. Okay, you make it. Alright, what would you like to dream about? Okay. And sit. Okay. Alright. Sleep well, have sweet dreams, and I will see you again very soon. Okay. Good night.